cherry on top for Fox College Football. The last, I mean last, piece to the Big 12 championship puzzle. Kansas State, number 12 with a bullet, wants a shot at TCU in the title game next week in Arlington. To get it, they got to take care of the Sunflower Showdown. It is the 120th renewal of this rivalry. The house is jumping. This is the first time since 95 that both teams have six-plus victories. It's also the first time this game has been televised nationally on an over-the-air network in prime time. 43 degrees. We do have rain. It's been raining since about an hour before the kick.
And Kim, that rain is going to be an equalizer, probably going to help Kansas out better, in my opinion, because of the way they plan to attack this Wildcat offense.
Tabor Allen will kick it away. Kansas State receives because Kansas deferred, which is already a surprise. Mm-hmm. And here comes Malik Knowles. Out near the 30-yard line before he is taken down. Third down and three.
Nice tandem. Four wide receivers across the routes. Should be open in the back. Should be open.
And the check down to Vaughn. A great tackle in space. Burrows, who made that outstanding mano-a-mano tackle, is back deep. Here's the punt from Ty Zentner, who's done both. Oh, yeah. He's done place kicking.
All the balls out. It's out.
It's out. And Kansas State is on top of it. The wind would be an issue, no question about that.
Tim, it's not just the wind, it's also the rain, because he slipped.
Yep.
As he seated that ball and his momentum has taken him backwards, watch that foot slip right out from underneath him, and he loses the handle on the ball.
And the elements already being heard from. On the setback, the 55 yards by Zentner really helped. Stretch play, Knowles, touchdown. The second touchdown run of the year for Malik Knowles, coming over from that receiver spot. And Burrows had a shot but couldn't wrap him up. Jason Bean checks into the game now. Look out. It's going to be Lachlan. There's some eye candy for you, Spence.
Yes, sir.
Touchdown, Jayhawks.
Oh, that's an excellent defensive play.
Third down and long. Pressure on the inside for Howard to deal with. This one is caught, and it's to Sinnott, who's become a real target in this offense in recent weeks. His star has grown.
Here comes a fire blitz off the edge.
Yeah, and the slant.
Whoa,
caught by Knowles, and he was dumped in a hurry at the 42 of KU by Burrows again. But he's been running well when he's had to.
He may have to occasionally run.
Yes, he will. This time he stays alive, looking long, he's wide open.
Wow.
No one is there. Sammy Wheeler, touchdown, K-State. Well, you just mentioned his name a moment ago after Sinnott made a catch. And this is a bust, an absolute bust. And credit Howard for keeping the play alive. 42 yards all year long. His sacks are down, but that's because of the concentration teams have had on him. Third down, nine.
Nice setup.
This pass almost picked off. And it was 23, right in position, Brits. And it looks like we've got a flag in the end zone.
That may be holding.
And if it is, it could be a safety. If it was holding in the end zone, it's two. Critical play, critical call coming up.
Holding, number 77, offense. That foul occurred in the end zone. The result of that is a safety.
They have given up a ton of yardage.
Absolutely.
On the ground. Vaughn.
Nice.
Hello. How do you do?
Well, on cue, Timmy.
Double deuce. Well, he was looking for his very first touchdown.
And that's what cost him. Third and 10. Howard. It is caught inside the 20. Move the sticks. Third down and 6. There it is to Giddens. And he's going to be taken out at the 4. DJ Giddens pulled out by Lorenzo McCaskill. K-State with an opportunity to grab a lead of 3 scores if they can punch it in.
Well, this play is
Knowles
so awesome.
Again. Oh, my goodness. He walked in. For Kansas offensively. First downs are even.
Nice play action.
Daniels in trouble. This is what he can do. He can beat you with his legs.
Yep.
And here he goes. Gets a nice block. Stays down the sidelines to get a few more yards.
Right here with the 3 receivers. They built it to 4 and there was no adjustment.
Daniels underneath. Caught by Neal. What a nice move Devin made to get it down to the 11-yard line. That's 6 yards and a first down. But a bit harder at this moment. Quick pitch to Neal. Look out. Devin Neal, touchdown. With K-State backed up on 3rd down and 12. 3 out of 4 on 3rd downs tonight.
Well, pressure again.
Underneath they go, and why not Vaughn? What a green in front of him.
Boy, he is subtle.
Look out.
He's
he
gone.
May take it the distance. Double deuce. He could go. Pushed out inside the 15 by Mello Dotson.
He's already there.
K-State looking to make it 14 in a row in this rivalry. No, that is caught by Brooks. Josh Brooks finally gets his touchdown. You know he wanted it badly. He felt like he had one in his grasp that he dropped a bit earlier on a slant. Not this time.
Well, here he is on the inside, Tim, and he does a nice job of slow playing this, understanding what Knowles did for him, just running an off route to take that traffic away, and he just found a soft spot and turned his head around on an outcut, a basic route. That's sacrificial play right there by Knowles, understanding how that play is designed for his teammate.
He drew some double coverage behind him, you're right. Second and 10 with trips to the top of your screen. Out of the gun. Daniels looking for Grimm. He's got it at the 45 and is out of bounds. Loves man-to-man coverage, and he moves up to the top of your screen. Grimm into the slot. And there they
nice
go
stop,
in that
bro.
Direction for Grimm. And they're going to have a marker in the end zone. That'll go against Boydo. He was coming back for it. You see this a lot on
pass
balls that are underthrown.
25. Defense.
Right there.
Bade in the to draw the penalty.
That happened to Ohio State a number of times today.
Nice.
Neal. Touchdown. Jayhawks. These defenses cannot solve the opposition's offense.
So
they'll have to punt it away on 4th and 12. Burrows is back deep. Remember, he had the muff
quick
earlier. Gonna let this one bound, and that is a huge kick. What a punt. Zentner has been one of the most valuable players on this Kansas State team over the last month. 72 yards on that boot. 3rd down 11. Daniels shoots it. It's caught by Arnold. But they're going to spot him a yard shy of the first down.
Throw. That's a tough throw to make.
I loved what Colin had to say about the pitching change that was made and how he had to think like his quarterbacks when the change was made.
Up.
There's that pressure. Ball's on the ground, and it's recovered by Kansas. It is a fumble. And it's Sampson that's on top of it. The hit comes from Lonnie Phelps. Walking in trouble. Great penetration. And that was the first time we got to call Felix Anudike Uzama's name. He and Austin Moore combined, but it was bit number 91 that made the initial contact.
And we call this a reduction here. This is almost a goat roping, man, right here, man. Rodeo style. He goes around the top of the neck. Almost gets him there, but that just shows you some of the athleticism this front Joe Klanderman told us they're outstanding, and they are, and they can do the job just between the three of them.
Yeah. Last five games, he's been shut down somewhat because of double teaming.
Nice.
Blocklin.
Ball's out.
Ball is out. Kansas State quick to get there. It appears they've got it. As they unpile, we'll see. Hayes is down there. The last to get up is Purnell, 32. Desmond Purnell with the recovery. And another early half miscue by the Kansas offense.
Yeah, the redshirt freshman comes up with it, man. He's got the goal. That's what they can ill afford to do, Tim. And I knew the game was going to slow down just a little bit because of the adjustments. But again, just getting that left shoulder in there.
Austin Moore with the strip.
The ball comes out.
And then
and
it's
a great Cheatham got in there as well.
Yep, Cheatham did too.
Craig Young. Now it's Craig Young, the outside linebacker. That's the matchup you want to exploit. This guy that's in motion, that's the matchup.
Vaughn. There he goes. Yards after contact. Big time. And a flag late. Face mask. Here we go. Fourth and goal. Out of the yard. Quick pitch.
In.
No one there. Touchdown. Double deuce. His seventh rushing touchdown, 10 total. And the lead up to 15 again. Here we go. It's fourth down.
Nice.
Daniels on his own. He'll get there. First down. Neal the setback. Ah, here's Daniels. Look out. He is there. Touchdown.
How about this formation? This is a quad. Okay, this, you got out four moves and you change this. They used this once already today. Got to go to that right side.
Bean.
Nice.
It is caught.
It.
It's Fairchild.
No, he dropped
the ball. That's the first time he's dropped one tonight in the end zone. Knowles is back deep. He's going to bring it again. He's extremely confident. And here's why. Malik Knowles trying to put a period on this one. In-your-face response from the senior from Mansfield, Texas. This offense runs through 22. Here he goes again. Here he goes again. And again. Shouldn't be a problem. It's a 13-point lead, which keeps this game in play. So even more at stake than just a shot in a rematch against TCU. They could climb in the BCS, excuse me, college football playoff standings. Neal, wrapped up behind the line by Felix and Udike Uzama.
I think USC is going to be the biggest benefactor.
They're the huge beneficiary after knocking off Notre Dame. There's no question. Knowles.
Nice.
They used him on this play, the sweep, all night long. Worked for touchdowns. Now he's just trying to put it away. For USC, Ohio State staying in the hunt. Look at Howard go.
Give advice to him, it would be one thing. Understand we live in a world of images and impressions. Most people are not willing to look past the veneer.
Yeah. There's Vaughn. Here's his moment. Inside the 15. Finally hauled down by Young, and he will not be denied.
Well, he's so effective. Again, we've made a point of this already, but I can't say it enough. I don't think there's a more effective inside runner that's this small, that this the size in the nation. I mean, he's so effective, and he's patient.
So much power
that he makes on the other end, and it has the consciousness to protect the ball at the conclusion of his run. I mean, this guy is just unbelievably gifted.
Line to make is the three for a first down.
He's in.
Line to make there is for a touchdown. It's Gibney's time. And I think Kansas State's success has put the pressure on Kansas to right the ship.
Yep.
And a guy like this, a guy on the other side, look at that. That's what it's all about.
Yeah. That's cool.
My guess is, you know, we waited a long time to have these two programs both have 6+ wins coming into this game. My guess is we'll see many more of those in the future. This matchup had never been seen in prime time on an over-the-air network. That will come to an end tonight and many times in the future. And the party is on, and a celebration with the rain coming down.
You're coming back.
Trust me, it's like holy water in Manhattan, Kansas tonight. Their 14th straight win over the Jayhawks. That's the longest win streak in series history. Two men that really respect one another.